Okay guys, welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. I had a quick look in this tower off screen, and it's actually not the one I remember, so I'm going to leave it for now, and if this wasn't the one I was looking for, then I'm pretty sure it's the one up top here. Because I think that's the only one, apart from the one I was talking about before, that's left in this level, so we'll go up there and have a quick look. I was debating whether to spend my 4,000 gold on a slightly better spell, but I think we're better off saving our money a little bit longer until we can afford a real upgrade. Yeah, let's see, how do we get to the top again? Is it up here? No. Wait a minute. Am I going in circles? I think I might be, yeah. I've forgotten how to get up there. Pretty sure you can do it like this, but again, it's one of those annoying jump tricks that I can never do right, so I'm gonna try and find a different way. You know what? Let's kill this guy too. I'm pretty sure there's no karma monsters on level 4, but I'm not 100% sure. So far we haven't killed any in any case. Oh yeah, this is the way. Here we go. So what we do is we go through this keyhole. And then we find the final tower. Clearly this is a more important one than the ones we've dealt with before. Wait, what? Did I see something up there? No. So this is the tower we're going to be tackling. Here we go. Itzamunas, which are generally fairly harmless, so we can kill them quickly. They do drop poison sometimes, so we have to be a little bit careful. Yeah, see. Shriekers, again, we'll zap them instantly because they drop food anyway. Because they have annoying deck spells. They don't do much damage, but any damage you can avoid is good. Chomp, chomp. Monodrones. Oops, these are the magic using ones. Let me check. Pretty sure they don't drop gold, but let me check real quick. AD? No, these aren't gold droppers. So these ones we will have to, or want to, kill with our axe instead. Which is easy enough once you have a few boxes to hide behind. Might need to make a map of this place because this looks like one of the more complex towers. It is used to layers, even though they do a lot of damage with their deck spell, or a lot, well, some damage at least with their deck spell. I wanna get them with my axe too, because there is the occasional variety of them that drops elixirs. This one is not the one I was talking about, clearly it drops poison. I think we'll go this way first. More shriekers. Not for long though. And even though food isn't a really good drop, 79 food is, or 790 food is only 79 in gold. It'll still help you get through the level without wasting any of your own food, so there's worse things to get, like poison. Pretty sure they don't drop poison. Yeah. Not that spectacles are really worth it, but you know. Even more shriekers, Jesus. No, I'm gonna leave these guys for a little bit. I'm gonna check this side first. some mono drones, which are only really dangerous if you get hit by their magic attack. See if they don't drop any poison. I don't think so, but yeah. We'll have a candle. More drones. Balance, kind of useless, but well. Yeah, this is this one, so we'll go the other way first. Again, with the shriekers. Get rid of them as soon as possible. And move on to the next area. This looks kind of useless. Now, I was talking about this in the overworld map before, about wasting keys that you don't need to because you can get there in other ways. When we came into the top side of this, we could have used the key to get to this room, but clearly we didn't have to. And the same is true for the room above here. You can use a key here, but instead you can just go down here and past the shriekers on the left and go back up without using the key. Keys are extremely valuable in this game, so really you don't want to use them if you don't have to. These are the moving type of Itazumas. Are these the ones that draw poison? They might be. But we'll see. Nope, these are the red potion ones. Okay. Occasionally we'll use a key just to get ahead because I think we explored all the non-key options. Now there might be an end boss in this tower, I'm not really 100% sure. I think this is where it came from. I think this is going back out the exit. I'm pretty sure, yeah. See, these towers are confusing. They'll turn you around, given a chance. But actually, that's okay. We're coming up on our time limit anyway. I'm going to... Yeah, there's no point. I'm going to cut off the video here, even though it's kind of going to be kind of a short one. And you know what, I'm gonna just look around this tower for a bit, see if I can find anything interesting, and I'll meet you back when and if I do. Okay guys, thanks for watching, and again, I'll see you in the next part.